Hi, I'm Andy.
And I'm Mark. Thanks for joining us today.
We'd like to introduce Oracle Backend for Spring Boot. It's available now on the OCI Marketplace. It can be installed on premises, on your laptop, or even on the Azure. It's the easiest way to develop and run Spring Boot applications with all the power of the converged Oracle database.
I keep hearing about this converged database. What exactly is that?
Well, you remember we used to have separate devices to make phone calls, take pictures, listen to music, get directions, track our exercise, and play games. They all had different interfaces, batteries, and nothing really worked together very well. And now these have all converged into one device, the ubiquitous smartphone. And it's not just that one device does all these things. The convergence also created opportunities for much more integration and innovative ways to create more value. It's a classic case of sum of the whole is greater than the parts. It's just the same way the Oracle database represents the convergence of relational data, JSON documents, graphs, text, spatial, machine learning, event mesh, and so on for OLTP and analytics. Instead of using different point solutions for each of these, each with its own requirements for configuration and patching, scaling, handling security devices, and so on, you can just use the Oracle database that does all these things in one place.
Wow, that makes total sense. So let me tell you about Spring Boot. Spring Boot is the most popular framework for building microservices today, not just by a little bit, by orders of magnitude. We know this from comprehensive analysis considering many data sources, including Stack Overflow questions, source code repositories, job advertisements, education, certification numbers, and Google search trends. We think it's so popular because you can get a lot done with very little code. There's a huge wealth of information available online, heaps of skilled resources, and there's a lot of support and integration from all the major vendors.
So Oracle Backend for Spring Boot brings these two great technologies together in an easy-to-use package. You get an instance of the Oracle Autonomous Database, the world's best database that's managed by AI to keep it secure, up-to-date, and to give you the best performance.
You also get a Kubernetes cluster with several Spring-related services pre-installed and pre-configured. Let me tell you about a few of them. There's the Spring Eureka Service Registry to provide service discovery, enable client-side load balancing and loose coupling of services. The Spring Config Server, configured with the Oracle database as the backend, to externalize configuration from your applications and container images and have it injected at runtime. And Netflix Conductor, so you can orchestrate and choreograph your services into processes with flow control constructs like forks and joins, decisions and variables.
That's great. And of course, you also get Oracle Transaction Manager for microservices, which allows you to easily manage data consistency and integrity across microservices. It supports XA, long-running action, and try confirm cancel, all three of the common methods in use today. And the API 6 API gateway to expose your services outside a Kubernetes cluster with great built-in features like security, authentication, traffic management, transformation, and observability.
Speaking of observability, we also include Prometheus, Grafana, Spring Boot Dashboard, OpenTelemetry Collector, and Jaeger. And when you deploy your services with our CLI or VS Code plugin, it's automatically configured so you'll get logs, metrics, and distributed tracing out of the box.
And let's not forget that the Oracle database includes transactional event queues, which provides a high-performance, low-latency event mesh with Kafka compatibility, Java, and REST APIs, and also a Kafka connector for interoperability.
What about development time? Well, we have a bunch of great features to help you develop your Spring Boot applications too. We've started publishing Spring Boot starters for various Oracle technologies. We started with UCP, JMS, Wallet, Soda, JSON, and we'll just keep adding to that list, making it easy for you to use Oracle from your Spring Boot applications. We provide an easy-to-use CLI and VS Code plugin to manage application deployment and scaling, access the platform services, and manage externalized configuration in the Spring Config Server.
Wow, that sounds like a lot of capability. To help you learn how to use all of this, we built the Cloud Bank sample application, which includes a number of Spring Boot microservices that demonstrate how to use the platform and implement best practices like database per service and loose coupling. It also includes a full implementation of a Saga using the long-running action specification and a mobile banking application that uses the Spring Boot services and the mobile services included in the backend.
That's right. We also include a full set of mobile app backend services. We think that microservices and mobile are better together. The platform includes all the backend services mobile app developers expect, like database, large file support, local offline storage on the device, push notifications, geolocation, configuration, cloud functions, and much more. And it's based on the Parse platform, which is incredibly easy to use and provides APIs and SDKs for the Apple and Android ecosystems, as well as JavaScript, Node, React, Flutter, Unity, .NET, PHP, C, embedded IoT, REST, and GraphQL.
And remember, when you run your Spring Boot applications on OCI, you can use Oracle Java and GraalVM for free. Spring Boot 3 added support for ahead-of-time compilation with GraalVM to dramatically improve startup time for Spring Boot applications, which works great in Kubernetes containers.
We've hinted at some patterns for microservices success, and the Oracle backend for Spring Boot is the embodiment of those patterns. They include patterns like database per service or bounded context, which deal with separation of a service's data store from its public API and prevention of spaghetti code or dependency hell.
Reliable event mesh and loose coupling are patterns that help us to make sure services can be easily evolved and scaled independently of each other.
The transactional outbox pattern and the Saga pattern deal with maintaining data consistency and preventing problems due to lost messages or duplicate delivery without all of the complexity of idempotent producers and consumers.
Wow, that all sounds great. If you'd like to know more, you can try Oracle Backend for Spring Boot for free with an Oracle Cloud trial account, or try our free live lab to learn more about it. The documentation is available at bit.ly/OracleSpringBoot, or you can drop us an email at obas_ww@oracle.com, or complete this short survey and we'll get in touch with you. Please take a moment and let us know what you think. We'd love to hear from you.